Nasa $100,000 na ang Bitcoin. Ang tanong ngayon, what's next? Yan ang pag-uusapan natin dito sa video na to. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Alam ko dapat live stream tayo today but meron tayong kailangang i-reschedule sa ating guest. So we'll just do the live stream next week. But for today, let's talk about Bitcoin kasi yan naman yung pinag-uusapan lately online. Just this week, nag-hit ng $100,000 ang Bitcoin and a lot of people reach out to me, nag-message sa akin na nagko-congratulate. And it's not a surprise because I've already said in this channel that I'm one of those who believe or at least hope na mag-hit ng $100,000 ang Bitcoin. There is still potential for more price rallies sa Bitcoin. Again, this is a logarithmic scale. And ang prediction is sa 2024, magkakaroon na naman ng halving. So if you want to hold your Bitcoin right now, I don't see anything wrong with that. So, pwede tayong mag-hold until 2024, which is actually what I'm doing. So, naniniwala ba ako na aabot ng $100,000 ang price ng Bitcoin? So, this is my belief. Yes, feeling ko aabot ng $100,000. Ang tanong ay kailan? So those videos were from 2021, no? Iba pa yung background ko at medyo malaki pa ako noon. But ngayon, ang tanong is, what's next? Well, first of all, I want to tell everyone that I've already sold all my Bitcoin. Nag-take profit na ako because sinet ko naman talagang target price ang 100,000. So noong nakita ko nagwo 102, 103 na siya, binenta ko na. Meron din akong mga iba pang coins, mga Ethereum and other altcoins. Soon enough, ay ibibenta ko na rin siya because I want to start the new year by 2025 na wala or zero muna ang aking crypto portfolio. Does that mean hindi na ako mag-i-invest or maglalagay ng pera sa crypto market? Not true. I am simply taking profit and it doesn't matter kung mag-continue pa siya pataas because I want to also taper my greed. But ang plano ko ngayon, and this is for everyone who's asking what's next for me, is magbo-monitor na lang ako ng price muna ng mga crypto assets, particularly Bitcoin, and I will wait for its correction or retracement before I start buying again. Sa mga conversations ko with other crypto enthusiasts and my friends, ang napipredict namin na correction or retracement level niyan is around 70K, 80K, but it really depends kung hanggang saan magpipik yung price ng Bitcoin this time. So for example, umakyat siya hanggang 150K, then probably mga 90K or 100K ang retracement level. But if it really goes up to 200K, then probably we will see around 120, 130K na retracement or correction level. So it really depends kung hanggang saan magpipik ito. But if it really peaks at around 100K, hindi na siya talaga umakyat. We are waiting at the 70K level to start buying again. Now, hanggang kailan naman namin ito i-hold? So, the next Bitcoin halving is predicted to happen in 2028 or 2029. So, hanggang doon sa years na yon namin siya i-hold. And hopefully, ang target price naman namin this time, if mabili namin siya ng around 70-80K, is 200K. Of course, these are soft targets. It really depends on what will happen in the market. But I will continue to update you and pag nagla-live stream tayo, tanongin nyo ako kung kamusta na yung ating crypto portfolio and I'll be willing to share with you kung ano yung ginagawa ko. Now, paano naman doon sa mga nafo-FOMO? And as I always say, kapag pinag-uusapan na siya, you're already late to the party. So, ang advice ko sa inyo is to continue educating yourself. Learn more about the crypto market, learn more about Bitcoin, and then try to find your own strategy and have your financial goals when it comes to the crypto investments or crypto assets that you want to put your money in. And then apply those strategies. Siguro you'll wait for a retracement or a correction in the price, and then that's when you start putting in money in the crypto market. At ganun din naman talaga yung ginagawa ko. Hinihintay kong bumaba ulit yung crypto and then slowly I will start buying again. So, saan kayo bibili ng crypto? Ang na-share ko na rito is primarily sa coins.ph or sa PDAX. But there's also an option sa GCash at saka sa Maya, which are both powered by PDAX. So, para sa akin, might as well go directly to PDAX. However, a good number of my altcoins are in coins.ph. All of these are regulated by the BSP, so hindi tayo matatakot na biglang ipasara or magsa-stop sila ng operations. So, check out these platforms if you want to invest or put money in the crypto market. And now, I guess the more important part of this video and the real lesson that I want to share with you is how do I manage my crypto portfolio? So, with that, I would like to share with you this illustration. So this is how I manage my portfolio, particularly with consideration sa crypto assets na hawak ko. So let's just say na at present, meron tayong 5 million pesos worth of investments that are in stocks, bonds, etc. Kaya siya time 1.0. And I want to invest in crypto. Ang philosophy ko kasi is ang crypto portfolio, very high risk. So, mga around 5% lang yung willing akong i-risk dyan. So, if I have 5 million pesos worth of assets in other investments, so let's just put 1.1 sa time. Ang gagawin ko dyan, ano ba yung 5% ng 5 million, which is 250,000? So, I'll probably sell some assets or some of my investments worth 250,000. Tapos, yung 250,000, yun yung ilalagay ko sa crypto market. So, yung magiging portfolio ko, before 100% in others, 0% in crypto, magiging 95% in others at 5% yung crypto. So, this is my ideal starting. And this is actually how I started. So, through the years, syempre, mag-iiba yung value ng crypto portfolio mo. Hopefully mayroon ding returns yung iyong mga stocks and bonds and other investments. So let's just say on the second period, siguro after 2 years, after 3 years, we don't really know, yung others mo, yung other part of your portfolios, sabi na lang natin stocks, no, para mas madaling sabihin, yung stocks mo ay worth 6 million na. Pero yung cryptocurrencies mo talagang lumago at naging 750,000 na yung value. So at this point, ano na yung weight nung stocks and crypto mo? So at this point, 89% is in stocks and 11% in crypto. Ako, I allow some volatility in my crypto allocation. Kung mga around 10%, I still just leave it be kasi minsan dumalago pa yan. Ang pinaka hard stop ko talaga or pinaka trigger ko to sell some of my crypto assets is when it goes above 15%. So ngayon na 11% na siya, I will evaluate the market. Do I think the crypto prices will continue to go up or nasa peak na siya? Kung nasa peak na siya, I'll probably sell 5 or 6% of it so that magiging 5% ulit yung allocation ko. Or if mukhang optimistic pa yung market at mukhang tataas pa yung mga prices ng crypto, I will just let it be. Now, what happens if talagang after 2 or 3 years, umakyat pa siya? Yung ating stocks or yung other part of our portfolio is 7.5 million na. Pero yung crypto assets natin, naging 1.5 million na ang price. Yan. So, ang magiging allocation niyan or ang weights ng others at yung crypto is 83% and 17%. So, at this point, I think it's time to take profit because I don't want a large part of my investment portfolio in crypto assets. So, I will probably sell some of the crypto assets. Let's just say I'll sell 1 million. So, ang matitira na lang ay 500,000. I'll sell 1 million worth of crypto. At syempre, i-invest ko pa rin yan pero sa ibang assets na. Probably, I'll buy more stocks, I'll buy more mutual funds, or probably invest in bonds. So, ito magiging 8.5 million na yung ating others, or a large part of it will probably be in stocks. So when we do this, ang mangyayari sa ating allocation is 94% in stocks or in others, at 6% na lang yung matitira sa ating crypto. And I think this is already a nice place or a nice way to continue on with my financial journey or investment journey. So that's how I manage my crypto portfolio, and I hope ay nabigyan ko kayo ng tip kung paano nyo ba pwedeng i-manage din yung inyong allocation. And as always, do not put a lot of money in crypto because it is high risk, highly speculative, but it's always good to have a little bit of money in it kasi may mga talagang magandang returns siya. As always, do not invest in something you do not understand. The first investment that you should have is on yourself first. Invest in knowledge. And that's our video for today. I hope ay marami kayong natutunan. Please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow our Facebook page for more videos. So kita-kita tayo next week sa ating live stream, and hopefully ay mag-enjoy din kayo dun sa in-invite nating guest. Hanggang sa muli, goodbye, take care, and stay safe. Bye-bye!